So the latest buzz, the latest FDA-approved glaucoma procedure is the iStent. And a lot of people have been really excited about the iStent. And in Canada, Ike Almond, who is an outstanding surgeon, has been a big proponent of the iStent. And for him, I think it works pretty well. And I'll tell you why it may work better for him in Canada than it would for us here in the US. So what happens with the iStent? So this is actually Ike Almond's procedure. So this is gonioscopic surgery, so that's a gonio prism. And this little device is the stent. It's a little snorkel-like device. And that there is the trabecular meshwork. And So what we're seeing here is the trabecular meshwork, and he's taking this stent and he's pushing it in through the trabecular meshwork, and there it goes, right into the canal. So Schlemm's canal. Once it's in Schlemm's canal, he's going to release it, and you see a little blood reflux out. And that's because, remember that the canal is connected to the collector channels, which is connected to the venous system. So when you actually open up the system, you can get some reflux of blood. And that reflux of blood is a good thing. That shows you that you've actually gotten into the system and the system is patent. Okay. So now here's where things differ between here and in Canada. In Canada, you can put in multiple of these little stents. Here in the US, they're only FDA approved for one at the time of cataract surgery. So Ike Ahmed's been getting great results from putting in these little stents, but he'll put in 3-4 at a time. Okay. And you can see, I mean, it's pretty neat to watch here. And you can see that reflux, so you know there's good flow. And here at the end of the case, and here I think he's going to put another one in even. Here he goes with a third one. It just couldn't do this here. And I'll tell you why. But once he puts it in, he's going to show you the actual flow through the system using some dye. So we'll put some dye in the eye, and you'll see the flow out through the collector channel system, and it's pretty impressive. But the issue is that these stents are $1,000 each. Okay, they're made out of surgical grade titanium, ounce per ounce, ounce for ounce. These are one of the most expensive things that you can possibly purchase. I think that the only thing more expensive than these by weight is antimatter. So here he goes. He's putting in this, and you see the blue dye go through there? He's going to do it again right there. You see that? It's neat. So you see this, you think, wow, okay, it's a neat procedure, it's low risk, it's not very invasive. You know, the thinking is that the iStent is a good technique for somebody who's having cataract surgery with ocular hypertension or mild open-angle glaucoma. It can be done with cataract surgery, so you're already there. But the problem is that it can potentially limit future surgeries. You're putting this tiny little stent in. If it works really well, great. Who cares about future surgeries? But if you're going to need future surgeries, such as, you know, canal-based surgeries, and you know, a lot of the really exciting surgeries that we either have now or will have are canal-based, you know, you don't want to close the door on something that's going to work really well with something that, well, let's see how well it works, shall we? Oh, and then it's also, like I said, it's expensive. At $1,000 a pop, you know, who's going to pay for that? So does it really enhance? The whole point of the iStent is to create an opening from the anterior chamber into the canal from the trabecular, you know, through the trabecular meshwork. Remember, this is a really tiny little lumen. Well, let's see. The results 1 year out, cataract surgery alone, 50% of patients who had elevated pressures ended up with a pressure below 22 millimeters of mercury. Cataract surgery alone. Cataract surgery plus the iStent, 72%. Okay. Well, there's a couple of ways to look at that. You can look at that and say, holy cow, cataract surgery treats glaucoma in 50% of patients, right? I mean, that's what most of us saw. to me, 72 versus 50% just wasn't that impressive, you know, especially for something that is expensive, may not be covered by insurance, could close doors on future options. So this is one of the reasons why I've not started implanting these things. Now, I comment again, he's learned that when you implant multiple stents, not surprisingly, you get more flow, you get the stents in near the collector channel system, you get a better result. But it's very important with these that you place them, he's learned, you have to place them where the patent collector channels are for this to work. So okay, so 1 year out, maybe you say, well, that's good enough for me. My insurance pays for it. It's easy. It's low risk. Hey, 72% versus 50%, I'll do it. What about 2 years out? 2 years out, published results, cataract surgery alone, 61% of patients ended up with a pressure reduction of less than 22 millimeters of mercury. The iStent, 71%. Well, now you say, well, it's still 10% more. Ah, but wait, that difference was not statistically significant, which means this doesn't mean anything. It's 10% may not be a real difference. Could just be a you know, you could redo the study and see those two flipped. So 2 years out, my reading of this is the iStent doesn't work. Doesn't buy you anything extra than cataract surgery alone. So again, if you've got patients who, you know, have insurance that's paying for it and they're low risk for progressing to more advanced glaucoma, it's like an insurance policy. But if they're paying out of pocket, I really don't see that they're getting much of value.